Hello and welcome to this latest video from simple-bbq.com. In this video I'd like to show you how I set my rotisserie up for rotisserie chicken, and I'm going to cook some potatoes underneath it. I just want to show you how I set up the counterweight. So with the chicken on the spit just resting in the barbecue stacker that I've got here, I'm going to put the counterweight up in the air so it balances the weight of the chicken, so you can see there. And I just test to make sure I have got a balance, so if there's anything wrong before I get it on the heat, before I stress the motor, I just want to make sure that everything's all set and ready to go. So satisfied with that, I'm going to now put the motor on, and that will just let me check everything out and put the seasoning on as I go. You can use whatever seasoning you like, and I just use a cocktail stick to just hold the chicken closed here, because I've got some lemon inside, but you can season it how you like. As I say, I'm going to do some potatoes, so I parboiled some slightly large new potatoes here, put a bit of oil in this foil lined tray, put that over the starter so I've got red hot coal underneath there, and just get things started. So these potatoes parboil for 10 minutes, and now I just want to make sure that they get a good coating of oil. But throughout the cook, these are going to have the juices from the chicken come drip down on them and impart a lovely flavour. So there's my coals, and I'm just going to put these either side of my Weber kettle. I'm using a 18 inch or 47 centimetre Weber kettle today, and I'm using my Backyard Barbecue Stacker with rotisserie, which fits on over the top of it. So coals in place, potatoes in the center, and I'm going to put the chicken on over the top of it. So before I committed to doing this all over the heat, struggling, perhaps even burning myself, I've got everything all ready to go, positioned on the spit in the middle, and we're all set. So once in position, spit rotating, lid on, and I'm going to leave that for about 45 minutes. And that's a good time to turn the potatoes midway through the cook. Obviously you've got to do your homework and make sure you get the timing on the chicken about right, but whatever your standard cooking time is probably a good place to start, and you can refine that process in the future. Obviously be sensible about this, check clear juices, and if you have a thermometer, check the temperature as you go. So this chicken's had about an hour and a half, so potatoes are good. They're sitting, you can see how the juices are caramelised. I only started with a little oil, so everything in there pretty much comes from the chicken. So it's well worth keeping those juices if you're planning on making some gravy, which would be a good idea. Look at that chicken, it's so moist. I promise you this is a really fantastic way of cooking chicken. And those potatoes. You could use normal potatoes, and obviously they'd get a bit more crisp, but these with the skins on, gorgeous. So thank you for watching, please subscribe, and make sure you check us out at the website, simple-bbq.com.